Many Britons enter the Spanish Basque Country by car. Motorists who've driven through France and continued south in the hope of finding life a bit less pricey. Others come to Spain direct, either by plane or aboard passenger car ferries like this one, the Swedish vessel Patricia, which has berthed here in Bilbao after a 37-hour, 555-mile trip from Southampton. She has 792 berths and room for 210 cars. Aboard, there's a restaurant, cafeteria, bars, lounges, a casino, and a swimming pool. Entertainment includes film shows and dancing to live music. Accommodation ranges from four-berth cabins, which last summer cost from £19 per person, to suites costing each occupant £55. The cost for the car depends on the number of passengers and ranges from £5 to £20. A caravan costs from £10 to £35. So for a motoring family of four with two children under 12, travelling half fare, the minimum cost of a single journey in high season works out at £67. It's double for return tickets, and considering that you have to pay for all meals, it's not exactly cheap. And what's more, prices will increase this summer. However, it does compare well with other passenger car ferries from England, northern Spain, and a fly-drive holiday from London to Bilbao Airport. Motoring holidays anywhere don't come cheap.
But whether you travel by sea, air or road, one thing is constant: facing customs. And someone on board this ship whose job it is to know about the various customs procedures is Ingrid Rosenberg. Ingrid, I think since we entered the common market, a lot of people are very confused about the different allowances from different countries. Can you explain the duty-free allowances?
Well, I try. If, in fact, you come back from an EEC country, you can bring back far more things than if you were coming back from a non-EEC country like Spain. And France, of course, being an EEC country. I've got some things out for you. These are the articles you can bring back from Spain. For instance, one bottle of spirits from Spain, 1.5 bottle of spirits from France.
And when you talk about bottles, these are litre bottles, aren't they?
Litre bottles, yes, and that's half a litre bottle. From Spain, you may bring back 200 cigarettes, and from France, you may bring back 300 cigarettes. Wine, you may bring back 2 liters from Spain and 3 liters from France. Perfume, coming from France, you may bring appreciably more, about 1/3 more than coming from Spain.
And what about gifts?
Gifts, you have an allowance of £10 per person if you come from Spain, which would buy you cassettes worth £10. If you come from France, you have a £50 allowance, which would buy you a beautiful radio cassette plus 5 tapes to play with.
Something that confuses me is the situation with fortified wine. Can you explain that?
Fortified wine, of course, is not a wine. It is an aperitif or sherry, for instance. So if you decide to bring that into the country, you will have to forego your liquor allowance. You may bring back, in fact, fortified wine instead of liquor.
From your side of the counter, what do you find that passengers find confusing about duty-free shopping?
Well, you just mentioned litre bottle, which is quite important, because so many people see price of a bottle of scotch in our shop, for instance, they say that is expensive. They don't realise that it is a litre bottle, which gives them 1/3 more than the standard bottle they normally buy at home.
Ingrid, thank you. Just to recap, because the situation is quite complicated, the only way you're entitled to the extra allowances, which Ingrid has described, is if you buy your goods in a common market country, but only in an ordinary shop or supermarket, not in a duty-free shop. If you buy your goods in a duty-free shop, or on an aircraft, or a ship, you're only entitled to the lower allowance, no matter which country you're coming from. It sounds rather complicated, but if you're any doubt at all, there are usually leaflets available at the ports or airports on the way out, and if you are in doubt, ask the customs men, who'll be pleased to help you. Last year, nearly 10,000 people were fined or sent to jail for trying to evade customs duty or tax. So take that as a warning.